little bit. Yeah, here. Look, we can just, we can fold it up right here.
Here, I'll let you start the introduction.
This is y'all's box.
Okay.
So, you know, you could go a little bit faster.
I just didn't want to block the sign.
Well, that's why I asked him if we could make sure the sign is in the back. Good morning. It is the big Saturday of Carnival here on St. Charles Avenue in New Orleans, Louisiana. I'm Victor Andrews with the Times-Picayune, New Orleans Advocate, and NOLA.com. And with me today is
Yvette DeLucky.
And we are going to be broadcasting live the parades of Iris and Tux, two parades that come down St. Charles Avenue with a long, long history, a lot of fun. It's going to be a great day. The sun is out. The weather is beautiful. It's perfect parade weather. So the parade is now just starting to come around Lee Circle, and we are going to be seeing the parade of Iris first. Iris is the oldest parading women's organization in Carnival. It's got a history that goes back to 1917. And leading off the parade is going to be the Marine Band. So we're going to listen to them as they come down the avenue. Yvette, while the band is stopped in front of us and we're waiting, just send out a reminder to everyone, our broadcast is being sponsored today by Gardner Realty, one of the leading real estate companies here in New Orleans, and in fact, in the entire region. If you are in the market for a home, or if you want to sell your home, contact one of the great agents at Gardner Realty. This is a family-run company. They've been in the New Orleans market for decades, and they know about living in New Orleans.
Here comes Texas A&M drill team.
Yes, the Aggies from College Station, Texas. You know, Yvette, there's a lot of marching groups that are leading off this parade, and it's one of Carnival's bigger parades. So it's great to see all of these different aspects, units joining in the parade. It's really what makes Carnival parades different from anywhere else.
And here comes Mount Carmel Academy. It's an all-female high school here in New Orleans.
the Carmelettes dance team.
And here comes Stevenson High School Navy JROTC from
DeKalb County in Georgia. Welcome to New Orleans, folks. And following them are the NOLA Nixettes. This is one of the many dancing groups that have popped up in New Orleans in the last few years.
Do a shout out to Karen Burkhead Bennett from Rhode Island.
Thanks for watching, Karen. Hope it's warmer in Rhode Island than it has been. You know, one of the great things with broadcasting over the internet like we do, we have folks all over the world that are watching what's happening here in New Orleans. So we're exporting Carnival to the rest of the world, and that's a very good thing.
Thank you all for watching and tuning in.
And now from Northfield, Vermont, the Norwich University Corps of Cadets, another sharp-looking military group. Yvette, there seems to be a whole lot of military groups at the beginning of this parade. The military always has had a very, very strong place in Carnival parades, and Iris is maintaining that tradition. And as I said, Iris is the oldest parading women's organization in Carnival, and they date back to 1917. And the captain of this organization, she is the third generation of her family to helm this organization. So it's a family affair as well. We've got another shout out.
Let's give a shout out to Brett from Slidell, Patrice Robichaux from Oregon, Nashville, Tennessee, Michelle McDonald. Oh, Pennsylvania, thanks for tuning in. That's Dina. Kathy, happy Mardi Gras to you. And oh, who dat, Michelle?
James Terrabone from Washington, D.C. He misses being home so much. James, you got to make it a point to get back to New Orleans sometimes. And Marion Treme in Elton, Louisiana.
Got a shout out to Kim Hines from Mobile, Alabama. Dolores Young, Eastern Oregon, another person from Oregon. Melinda Fletcher Vergona, I hope I say that right, Melinda, from Arkansas. Diana Pius, I guess, from Idaho. Kathy Menninger from snowy Vermont. It's not snowing here.
No, but from Monroe, Louisiana, the Carroll High School Marching Band and the Carolettes. What an outstanding group of young ladies. They have got some moves. Now, Yvette, you're a native of New Orleans. Did you grow up marching in parades?
I did not.
Well, neither did I.
He's a spectator.
Which is great, but I tell you what, These kids and the chaperones and the band directors work so hard marching in these parades, and they bring a lot of excitement and a lot of entertainment to the crowds along the way. And I'm sure at the end of the day, they're pretty tired.
Oh, I know. I did ride on floats, Victor, and that was exhausting and a lot of fun. But it's also a lot of fun to be a spectator.
Absolutely. And we're glad those of you who can't be with us today in New Orleans are watching us live from our offices here on St. Charles Avenue, sponsored by Gardner Realty.
Some more shout outs here. Charlotte Files from rainy Camp Pendleton. It's sunny in New Orleans, Louisiana. Candace from Austin. You did not miss the Queen's Float yet. Paulette Black from Norman, Oklahoma. Cheyenne Fernandez, Grand Rapids, Michigan. Teresa Northrup from Florida.
Another one of the amazing marching groups that walk with the parades, and their costumes are vibrant, brightly colored flowers, and they add so much to the pageantry that is your basic carnival parade, though no parade in New Orleans is basic.
Let's give some shout outs to Courtney Scott from Tennessee and Stacy Smith all the way from London. She said she's from New Orleans and she misses us. Stacy, I don't know how the weather is in London, but I have to tell you, it is a gorgeous day here in New Orleans and the crowds are phenomenal.
And coming down the street on horseback are the Iris Cavaliers. You know that riding lieutenants are a very old tradition in carnival. Of course, the early carnival parades, the floats were pulled by mules and riders on horseback. Most of the lieutenants of the crews are the officers of the organization. That's how they did the parade routes. And Iris has brought this tradition to their parade, which is wonderful. And coming up now, it's the captain of Iris's float.
Thank you.
This is the Alfred Bonneville Magnet High School Marching Band.
Yvette, we got a shout out going to Evans Lelengwini from Nairobi, Kenya. Thanks for watching.
A shout out to Liz from Little Rock, Bob from Illinois. We got Howard Stein from Northwest Iowa. There you go, Ed Jack from your neck of the woods, Victor.
From Lafayette, yes indeed. Lafayette has a growing carnival. It's not quite as extensive as New Orleans, but they're very proud of their carnival traditions there in Lafayette. And you know, right outside of Lafayette, a lot of the small towns and cities have a very traditional courier de Mardi Gras, which is they ride on horseback and they ride through the countryside on Fat Tuesday, collecting the ingredients for a gumbo. And it's something that has been going on for hundreds of years in Cajun country.
That's from your neck of the woods too, right?
Well, a shout out to Vanessa who's watching from Shag Bay. Thanks for watching, Vanessa. Mike, yes, New Orleans is a great city. There's a lot of great stuff here in New Orleans. And coming down the street now is the arrival of the Queen. The Queen of Iris this year is Miss Rebecca Russo, and she is, as usual in the Iris Parade, she's wearing a beautiful gold gown, and her collar, a lot of people ask about the collars, it's called a Medici collar, and the petals kind of frame her face, and this is pretty typical of most of the carnival queens. And of course, no queen is going to have to move around her own dress and stuff, so she's got some pages, and they are...
The pages to Her Majesty are Miss Parker Rain Bertucci, Miss Harlow Rose DeVell, Master Noah Stanley Mathis, and Master Graham Ryan Stoltz.
Well, and it looks like this Queen of Iris is having a good time.
Okay, following Her Majesty is Sophie B. Wright Charter School Marching Band. Right here from New Orleans.
You know, Yvette, one of the things that I write here at the paper are the carnival ball stories. And Iris's ball is very interesting in that the maids and the dukes each portray part of the theme. And so what we're seeing now is a long tandem float that have the maids and the dukes, and they each represent part of the theme. And so we're going to start off with the Saints and the Pelicans. And this is made Kelly Ann Stoltz and Joshua Nathan Stoltz. Joshua's got the pelican on his headdress, and as you can see, Kelly's got the elaborate Saints logo on her mantle. And behind them are Space and the Moon Landing, Michelle LeBlanc and Peter Vincent Russo. And then in yellow, it's Birthdays and Anniversaries with Anna Terrio and Rene Bourgeois. And now, coming up behind them are New Year's Eve with Morgan McAllister, Kruliski, and her Duke Peyton Terrio. And then right after that, School Days and Graduation with Macy Ann Orsorno and Chase Orsorno. And then in the vibrant pink, it's Travel and Transportation with Brittany DeVille and Kyle Julian Sanderson. And next up are the junior maids and the ladies in waiting. This is another one of the great traditions of old line carnival cruise like Iris, where there are places in the court and at the ball for young children to get exposed to the intricacies and the elaborateness of carnival balls.
Following the Maids and Dukes, Dr. King High School Marching Band. Let's give a couple of quick shout outs. Rob Watkins from Disney World. Patrice Robichaud, living in Oregon for work. Gen Hathaway, homesick for New Orleans, watching from Washington. Cheryl Pierre, watching from here, New Orleans. You need to be out on the street, girl.
For those of you that are just joining us, we are broadcasting live from the offices of the Times-Picayune, the New Orleans Advocate, and Gambit, and NOLA.com on St. Charles Avenue, and we are brought to you by Gardner Realty, one of the leading real estate companies here in the New Orleans area. If you are in the market for a home, if you want to move down to New Orleans and become part of Carnival, Gardner Realty can find you the perfect place to live.
Thank you.
little reminder that the Endymion route has changed this year. So it will not be passing here in front of the Times-Picayune New Orleans Advocate home office.
We have a little bit of a break in the parade right now.
Introduce to you all somebody from New York that's here for the first time for Mardi Gras, and this is her first parade. So we'd like to know, how are you enjoying it?
It is unlike anything I've ever experienced. And being from New York, I've been to lots of Thanksgiving Day parades and St. Patty's Day parades, but nothing compares to being here for Mardi Gras. It's unbelievable.
So all the things that you heard, were you able to envision it to be quite like this?
I definitely think that being from up north, we have a misconception of what Mardi Gras is. It has been that much more, actually. Just the people are amazing. The atmosphere is so exuberant and everyone's having a great time. It's nothing I ever imagined.
Well, I'm glad you're here to enjoy Mardi
Thanks
Gras
for
with
having us.
Us. And I think the parade is starting to kind of move
it's so
up.
Amazing. The floats. Everything. Look at all the pee. It's been great.
Well, good. Glad you came.
Thanks for having us.
All right. And Victor, what do we have coming up the street? All right. So float number four is the past Court of Iris. Did you know that New Orleans gauges the success of Mardi Gras by the amount of garbage that is collected?
Isn't that amazing? Yes. They estimate the tonnage, and the bigger the mess, the better the Mardi Gras. But there are several crews that are trying to cut down on the amount of waste at Mardi Gras this year to make Carnival a little more environmentally friendly. All right, and next up, it's the Moss Point High School Marching Band.
Live broadcast is brought to you by Gardner Realtors. We are streaming live from the home office of the Times-Picayune New Orleans Advocate, NOLA.com, here on St. Charles Avenue in downtown New Orleans. Float number five, Iris's Garden. Hey. Okay, coming down the street is St. James High School Marching Band.
While we're waiting for the next flood to come by, let's talk just a little bit about this crew. Their theme this year, Yvette, is Iris Sees 2020. Of course, it's the year 2020. And they recently held their carnival ball down at the Hilton Riverside. I don't know if you've ever been to the Iris Ball, but it's a pretty elaborate fair. They do an entire tableau, and they bring out members of the crew that will ride on the parade, and they'll bring them out onto the ballroom floor. They parade their past court, and then they bring out this year's court, which we've just seen pass by, and then they stage an elaborate supper dance. But they picked a very interesting theme, Iris Sees 2020, and we're going to see it throughout this parade in their float.
Because their signature throw, every carnival crew generally has a signature throw, and theirs is sunglasses.
Well, yes, so we'll be seeing, right? 2020 through shades.
And we need them, because today is a gorgeous day.
We had some rough weather to start the week off, but you know, since Friday, it's just been beautiful. They couldn't ask for better weather today. Let's just keep our fingers crossed that this weather holds out through Mardi Gras.
Okay, Emily, we see that you're watching us. Let's give a couple of shout-outs here. To Lori, she's loving the tree that's wearing so many beads. Some of that's by design, some of it's just because people on the floats can't throw. Jacqueline Pearson, she's in Georgia. Albert White, strong legs. And a ladder.
Mardi Gras is a marathon. You can't just come out and think you're gonna sprint through a couple of parades. And especially on a day like today, where we're starting with Iris, which will be followed by the crew of Tux, and then end in one of the largest parades in the world, the crew of Endymion, and they'll be taking a little bit of a different route this year because the Superdome is under renovation. So whereas they usually parade into the Superdome for their star-filled extravaganza, they'll be parading down to the New Orleans Ernest N. Morial Convention Center, where they'll go in and they'll have top-notch entertainment and dance until the wee hours of the morning. LaGuala Pay, it's a shout out to you. One of the reasons why the parade seems to have come to a stop is about three blocks from us down St. Charles Avenue is Gallier Hall, which used to be City Hall for New Orleans. And this is traditionally where the mayor and other city officials watch the parades, and generally the captain and often the ruling monarch, whether it's a queen or a king, will stop and have a toast and exchange a few words with the mayor. So the parades tend to come to a little bit of a stop right here, but once those parade officials go through, things tend to run pretty quickly. And it looks like this parade is picking up again, and we are looking at another float. Yvette, what's coming down the avenue at us right now?
Okay, float number six, it's the title float, Iris Sees 2020. And I want to give a quick shout out to Brandy Torres.
You know, the Iris floats are known for their beautiful colors and their elaborate costumes, and they're living up to their reputation again in 2020.
Avenue is Crew of the Rolling Elvi.
Yeah, this is one of those really unique groups of marchers, and some of them ride in homage to Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll. Many of these guys decked out as Elvis, and I see a few Priscillas in the group too. And here come the Rolling Elvi on scooters.
Approaching is float number seven, Summer Olympics. Also want to give another shout out to Connor and Hunter Torres.
Yeah, you've got to have an Olympic flame to have a float about the Olympics. And this one has a brilliantly lit cauldron on the front. Are the Ramblers, a fixture in many, many carnival parades. This local group of musicians are seen throughout the metro area. And in keeping with the sports theme, Yvette, it looks like we're going into, well, not yet, but soon it'll be
football season
with the Lombardi Trophy on the front. You know, it's time to bring that trophy back to New Orleans.
Can I get a hoot at?
Yes, indeed. One of the riders has Superdome beads, and as you can see, the front of this float is a replica of our own Superdome. And it looks like we're going to have Drew for one more year to roam in the dome.
That's exciting. He's made a lot of whodats happy.
Very happy.
Following the float football season is the Greenville High School Marching Band.
Are you going to catch beads that have the Superdome on it?
I'll challenge you to some football in the street later, okay?
All right. I'll tell you now, I'm pretty bad at it.
Yeah, well, I'm not any better. But we'll give it a hell of a try, right?
Absolutely.
Here. Sharon Burgess watching from Bermuda. Heather Houdat from Fayetteville, Arkansas.
Home of the University of Arkansas Razorback.
Lynn Campbell watching from Mississippi. She's coming here tomorrow. I hope you're coming here through Mardi Gras.
Yes, and from up in the Delta, Greenville, Mississippi. It's the Greenville High School Marching Band. You know, Yvette, we get bands from all over the country that come in for Mardi Gras. They work hard, and they do bake sales, they do car washes, they do all sorts of fundraisers to be able to afford to come to Mardi Gras and to be part of Carnival in New Orleans. And speaking of being part of Carnival in New Orleans, you know, folks that are thinking about relocating to New Orleans to be a permanent part of Carnival, they need to check out Gardner Realtors. They're our sponsor, but they're also one of our city's great real estate companies.
The World Series, the future daughter-in-law, Dr. Hallie Peterson. So I'm stepping away from the mic for a 1 minute, Victor. It's all yours.
Yes, and it's batter up. All right, and coming next down the street, another one of our unique and infamous, or should I say famous, marching groups, the Amelia Earharts. Yeah. This is a sharp-looking bunch of ladies.
They sure do know how to have a good time on a parade.
Absolutely. I love their slogany that, can you handle the turbulence?
Okay, guys, coming down the avenue is float number 10, space travel. Now, Victor, how many people do you think is on that float, if you had to guess?
That float probably has close to 100 riders on it. I mean, it's packed. It is packed. It's two decks. And it's a tandem float, so that means it's got another float connected to the back of it. This is one of the new trends in Mardi Gras for these tandem floats. The Irish ladies today are being very generous with their throws. In fact, they keep pummeling our cameraman with throws. But we love it, and the crowd loves a generous parade. This is the Maplewood High School Marching Band. Now, Yvette, these guys were in a parade last night, and here they are marching again today. Goodness knows how many parades they'll be marching in. And this is true about a lot of our local schools and our out-of-town schools. These kids march in a night parade, they'll turn around, they'll march in a day parade the next day. They may even march again tonight.
Victor, I was exhausted just from being on the parade route all day and night. I just can't imagine. But again, they're young.
This is true. We used to do a lot of things when we were young.
Float number 11, Happy New Year.
And that is one interesting looking baby New Year there on the front of the float. I have welcomed some New Years like that, I have to say. Maybe not quite like that.
Here comes the Douglas High School Marching Red Devils from Memphis, Tennessee.
Leave it to the ladies of Iris to come up with some really interesting throws, including a real live Iris. School.
Here from New Orleans, Louisiana.
Watching from the baseball field in Atlanta, where her two kids play baseball. Hope y'all are having a good day, Carmen. It's time for you to come back to New Orleans for Mardi Gras.
All right, Bridget, you want to know if we are on the sidewalk side or the neutral ground side? We are on the sidewalk side.
You know, in other parts of the country, they refer to the neutral ground as the median, but here it's the neutral ground. And the legend has it that back when the French Quarter was mostly French and downtown New Orleans was mostly American, the center of Canal Street was considered the neutral ground between the two sections of New Orleans. So everybody refers to it now as the neutral ground. You know you're talking to somebody that knows about New Orleans if they ask if you're going to be on the sidewalk side or the neutral ground side.
Mardi Gras t-shirts that state neutral ground side or sidewalk.
Yes, and we are on the sidewalk side at 840 St. Charles Avenue at the home offices of the Times-Picayune, the New Orleans Advocate, NOLA.com, and Gambit, and we are brought to you today by Gardner Realtors. And the next float up, Yvette?
Float number 13, Beach Vacation.
Yes, indeed. With mermaids and palm trees, this three-unit float is enormous. It is giant. And the ladies on board are having a fabulous time. They're throwing lots and lots and lots of items. And one of the unique things that they're throwing are glass beads. Yvette, you know, a lot of the crews are concerned about the amount of plastic in the environment. And there's a lot of plastic beads. But
I'm kind of showing my age, but I remember when all of them pretty much were glass beads.
All right, and coming up next, it's pipe and drums, yes, kilts and everything.
It's the kilts of many colors.
This couple on the front looks like they may be putting on the Ritz, as it were.
Hey!
R.A.D. Cog Hill Charter Marching Band. Marching Cougars.
And next up, float number 16. What have we got, Yvette?
Art.
Art. Mona Lisa on the front. And their costumes are their cute little French berets, painters.
Watching that, you all noticed that our poor cameraman has been getting pelted with beads and trinkets. Now, while the Endymion route has changed and won't pass in front of our office this evening, tomorrow we will be broadcasting again live all day and all night, ending with Bacchus tomorrow evening.
It's going to be a full day of parades, and we can only hope that the weather holds out tomorrow as it is today, because it's just, the city will just be parading all day, all evening. Pretty much the same as tonight, just in a different area.
Coming down the avenue is float number 17, European Vacation.
I could use a European vacation, Yvette. How about you?
I could. Have you ever had the chance to travel overseas, Victor?
As a young person, I did make it over to England, which, you know, the folks in England will tell you they're not really part of Europe. So, no, I haven't made it to Europe, but I have made it to England and Scotland, and hopefully I'll get back there soon. Of course, on the front of this float is the Eiffel Tower, and New Orleans being America's most French city, I guess it's apropos that a float dedicated to a European vacation has a Parisian hotspot on the front of it. Thank you. Providing some musical entertainment is the Just Doing It Band, another fixture in carnival parades. And coming down the street now, we're just on float 18.
Happy anniversary. Okay, coming up is Tom Benson Middle School Marching Band from Kenner, Louisiana. Thanks for the compliment, but it really all goes to Victor. He's so well versed on everything Mardi Gras. It's amazing.
We're glad you're watching, Lori. Thanks.
Let's give a shout out to Kristen Jackson from Detroit. Ron Summers.
Deanna Lachelet from Lafayette, thanks for watching. Mark Orgeron, San Diego Marine from New Orleans, watching here. Semper Fi.
And Kathy Ann from Wisconsin. Victor, you must know a Roberta Lee. Or maybe she's just complimenting you because you know everything Mardi Gras. I say yay, Victor.
Thanks, Roberta. Thanks for watching. And look, Yvette, here comes our next float. It's only number 19.
And it's Halloween.
It's Halloween indeed.
Victor, we have the Arthur Ashe Charter School Marching Band.
Named after the famous tennis player Arthur Ashe, he broke several color barriers and was just an incredible athlete and a great guy. I was a big tennis fan when Arthur was playing, and he really has a great legend. It's wonderful to see a school named after him.
Roberta Lee says she's a NOLA girl living in Houston. She goes, I know y'all, and I love y'all. Well, we love you, too.
That's right. Keep that NOLA fire going in Houston. I've got a lot of friends in Houston, former New Orleanians, and a big shout out to my friends Susan and John in Houston. I'll be seeing them soon. Houston is a great city, and we've got a lot of great former New Orleanians, a lot of great former Louisianians living in Houston. Y'all should consider coming back home.
Dorothy and Jennifer from Tulsa, Oklahoma, hope you're enjoying this live broadcast.
Thanks for reminding me. Yes, indeed, we are live, ladies and gentlemen, from New Orleans, Louisiana, St. Charles Avenue. These are the home offices for the Times-Picayune and the New Orleans Advocate, NOLA.com, Gambit Weekly, and our webcast is brought to you by our sponsors, Gardner Realty. You know, this company was established in 1943. They know the greater metro New Orleans area backwards and forwards. They can help you buy a home. They can help you sell a home. Amazing, amazing people. In another lifetime, I used to write about real estate, and the Gardner Realtors were always great, great sources of information. They will help you make the best decision for you and your family.
Okay, coming down the avenue, float number 20, St. Patrick's Day.
Gosh and bigora, it's a leprechaun on the front. And look, Yvette, there's the pot of gold. Fannie C. Williams marching warriors are making their way down the avenue right now. This is a sharp-looking group in electric blue and white. And I tell you what, it's such a beautiful day here. The sun is reflecting off their uniforms and off their instruments. But nothing beats being here in person and listening to that sound. So we're going to give these guys a chance to impress you.
Okay, float number 21 is approaching. Christmas is the title.
Yes, Santa's elves are busy working on the front of this float. I am liking their wigs, Yvette. It reminds me of the old style tinsel we used to put on Christmas trees. Of course, I was the kid that always just wanted to throw big handfuls of it on the tree, and my mom was always, one strand at a time, one strand at a time.
Let's give a shout out to Ryan. And let's give a shout out to Marion Richards from the UK.
And it looks like Lori is watching us from Southwest Michigan. Mary Kelly in Chicago. Say hi to all my friends in Chicago, Mary. We're glad you're watching. And there's Mr. and Mrs. Claus.
Okay, here's the Encore Academy Marching Band.
Dragons. There be dragons in the streets. And look, here's the school's mascot with his wings out. Yvette, it looks like there's a tank rolling down St. Charles Avenue, but I know it's just a carnival float.
I think so. It's float number 22, Armed Forces.
So here's a big shout out to all of the women and men around the world who are wearing the uniform of the United States. We appreciate what you do. Thank you for your service. I got to give a special shout out, Yvette, to my niece, Kate Andrews, who is a pilot in the U.S. Navy. Kate, chances are you may not be watching, but we miss you and appreciate what you do.
Let's give a quick shout out to Cindy Bordelon-Kinney and to LaDonna Blair from Missouri.
Thank you.
want to thank all of you all that have tuned in to this live broadcast from the Times-Picayune New Orleans Advocate NOLA.com home office here on St. Charles Avenue and the Gambit. This is brought to you by Gardner Realtors. And coming down the avenue is float number 23, Thanksgiving. Victor, what would you say is your favorite holiday?
Besides Ash Wednesday, when that woman stops blaring the horn? No, Carnival is my favorite holiday, followed by Christmas.
You know, mine as well. This group is called Band of America's Few.
Float number 24, Easter. Another really, really good holiday. And coming down the street now is the Sarah T. Reed Olympian Band from right here in New Orleans. We got a couple of shout outs, Yvette.
Yeah, Tim Worth watching from Tampa, Florida. Gregory Powers, when the Saints go marching in. Mary Kelly from Chicago, the Windy City. Give a shout out to Patty Chase. She's from Pennsylvania. Her daughter is on float 22.
Well, Patty, that was 24, so your daughter was two floats ago. I hope she's having a great time. But I tell you what, Yvette, it looks like these riders are having a wonderful time today. So, Yvette, is this next float coming down? Is this our favorite holiday?
It is my absolute favorite holiday.
It's carnival time!
Now, Victor, do you dress up for Mardi Gras Day?
No.
Okay, so every year, you know, me and the family, we all get together and make a costume and come out as a group. It's like the best time ever.
I have seen your family costumes, Yvette. They are incredible. It's the new Schaumburg Charter School Marching Band. Renew Schaumburg. You know, Yvette, New Orleans is a real big sports city, and we've hosted Super Bowls and the Women's Final Four, and this next float that's coming up
is the NBA Finals.
It's amazing, you know, the city that brings carnival to America. The greatest free show there is. We also do a great job with major sporting events. And from the looks of this guy on the front of the float, I'm sure it's a three-point play.
I need to give a special shout out to my nephew, Brett Accardo, watching live from New Jersey. Love you, Brett. Wish you were here. I've caught so many beads for you. You need to be here so you can ride Mardi Gras Day. Love you guys. Love Shauna and Olivia and Nona. Float number 26 is the Samuel Green Charter School Marching Band from New Orleans. Okay, float number 27 is approaching the Aquarium of the Americas.
Aquarium of the Americas and Audubon Zoo float is one of New Orleans' unique and interesting marching groups. Who are they, Yvette?
NOLA Cherry Bombs.
That's a lot of red tutus. Just a reminder, everyone, we are coming to you live from St. Charles Avenue in New Orleans, Louisiana. It's Carnival 2020. Parade, and our next float is number 28. as we were talking about, New Orleans really knows how to put on a sports event, and we do it with tennis and golf here in the city, as well as football, basketball, and more.
Okay, here's the Langston Hughes Marching Band.
From right here in New Orleans.
So, Victor, we did a shout out to Sherry Snyder in Italy, and I hurried up and called her to make sure that she heard it. And she said she did, and she loves us, and she misses us. So I think we should really talk her into coming down next year for Mardi Gras.
Absolutely. Sherry, Bella, come to New Orleans. Just a reminder, we are coming to you live from the offices of the Times-Picayune, the New Orleans Advocate, Gambit Weekly, and NOLA.com here on St. Charles Avenue in New Orleans. And we are sponsored by Yvette.
Gardner Realtors.
One of the leading area real estate companies. And the Crew of Irish Parade continues. This is a monstrous parade. It is just giant. And these ladies are being very generous today. I think this great weather has really brought out a great attitude in everybody. The crowds are huge. The throws are massive and many. And the floats still keep coming. And here's number 29.
New Orleans festivals.
We do love a festival here in New Orleans. Rode by on the festival's float and pummeled us with beads. And our next float, number 30, 4th of July, Lady Liberty on the front. We have just enjoyed hearing the Worley Junior High School marching band. I'm sorry, that was the Crocker College Prep School marching band. Coming up next is float number 31. Two of my favorite seasons as well, crawfish and snowball season. And the crawfish are just now starting to come in, Yvette. They're telling me that they're big and sweet this year, so I can't wait to get me some ball crawfish. Interview right now. Here we come, float number 32.
Palace of Iris, look at this. It's four tandem. Four floats.
It's enormous, enormous.
down the avenue is the Youth Empowerment Program drum line and dance team. In the distance is float number 33, the Iris Butterfly. That is the end, or the tail end, of this parade. Everybody has enjoyed themselves immensely.
Well, the ladies of Iris always do a great job with their street pageant. This is the last float in Iris. It's the Iris Butterfly. Oh, and they are spraying Silly String on the crowd. Shout out to our colleague Xana on this last float. She looks like she's having a great time. So that wraps up the Crew of Iris Parade for 2020 here on St. Charles Avenue. They've got a few more blocks to go before they disband, but a tremendous parade, don't you agree?
It was tremendous indeed, and we had a great time, and I hope you all had a great time watching.
We really enjoy bringing this to you live from the offices of the Times-Picayune and the New Orleans Advocate, Gambit Weekly, and NOLA.com. And our sponsors, Gardner Realtors. We're so thankful to them that we can bring this to you live. And we've got one more parade coming after this, this afternoon. Crew of Tux is rolling, and they'll be here. So stay with us. We're going to take a short break, but we'll be back. welcome back. We are live from St. Charles Avenue in New Orleans, Louisiana, in the middle of the biggest weekend of Carnival 2020. I'm Victor Andrews with the Times-Picayune New Orleans Advocate. And with me?
Yvette DeLucky.
And we are here broadcasting live from our offices on St. Charles. And we are brought to you by Gardner Realtors, one of the leading real estate companies in our area. We're delighted to have Gardner as our sponsor. And we are fixing to see the first elements of the crew of Tux. This slightly irreverent, always fun crew is fixing to roll right past us. And we're starting off with the Shriners, a fixture in these parades. It's always great to see the Shriners. You know, these guys do so much good work. They help fund hospitals, and they have a lot of children's charities. So we're gonna roll right over to the parade. Yvette, the theme of this year's parade, you know, Tux, they have to do everything with very tongue-in-cheek. Their theme this year is...
Tux hits the sweet spot.
You know, this is an interesting organization. It goes back to a group of Loyola students gathering at a bar that was called Friar Tux. And they wanted to participate in Carnival, and they formed this organization, and it's been growing strong ever since. They, as this group parades down the avenue, they will go to their extravaganza party afterwards. And if you read in tomorrow's Times-Picayune New Orleans Advocate, there will be a write-up about this ball, and it's quite interesting. But reigning over the ball tonight will be King Kevin Hellman and Queen Amy Creel. And they were crowned at the group's Carnation Ball a few weeks back. But today, it's all about the parade. There'll be floats, there'll be bands, there'll be marching units. There'll be all sorts of stuff. And right now, some of the most interesting Shrine vehicles are rolling by. As I said, we are coming to you live from St. Charles Avenue in the heart of the Central Business District for New Orleans. We are on the main parade route. Almost every parade through the city of New Orleans passes us by, except tonight, Endymion will turn before it gets to our offices. And we are starting things off with the Urban Cowboy Rider Club from Abita Springs on some pretty majestic horses.
Thank you.
Antoinette Jackson from Ohio, Ryan Dupuis coming from LaFouche Parish in Thibodaux.
And coming down the street, it's a most amazing sight. It's dragons and other fantastic creatures. These self-propelled or human-propelled floats are rolling with lots of color, lots of imagination, always a crowd favorite. These have been in parades for years and years and years. I'm glad to see they're still rolling with Tux. It's the Dragons of New Orleans. You know, Yvette, if I'm not mistaken, years ago this started as an art project by one of the art teachers at a local high school, and it just really has blossomed and exploded into something truly unique. It's a real slice of carnival. It shows the imagination and the difference that you'll see in marching groups from parade to parade and even from group to group. And now for all you Star Wars fans, we have representatives of the 501st Legion. I see some Imperial Stormtroopers. I believe that's a Jawa over there. We've got some TIE fighter pilots, and we have some of the revolutionary pilots out there too.
And on horseback is the Cajun Indians and Cowboys.
Amazing costumes on some of these riders, Yvette. Absolutely stunning. And they're throwing lollipops. Speaking of marching groups, we have another one coming up right now, Yvette. This is Colossus. And we saw them last night in a parade. They marched in one of the five parades last night. And part of their unit rides tricked out tricycles. And this isn't a tricycle like we learned how to ride bicycles on. These are three-wheeled cycles with some very imaginative fronts and backs. We see grasshoppers and bees and a panda bear, a hammerhead shark. Horses. I'm a big fan of the twin bats, though. Those are pretty cool. Yeah.
Here comes the purple marching machine of Miles College out of Fairfield, Alabama.
Alabama in the house. Coming down the avenue, we see one of the most interesting royal carriages in all of Carnival. Tux sits on a, quote, throne, more apropos, a very large toilet. Only Tux would have their monarch on a giant toilet. But it is Tux. And you know, one of the most interesting things this crew throws are decorated plungers and toilet bowl brushes. And who's our king again this year, Yvette?
It's King Kevin Hellman.
King Kevin seems to be having a grand time aboard his royal throne.
Thank you.
Texas throne.
Kentucky, thank you.
From Frankfort, Kentucky. Kentucky band. I'll tell you what, Tux is starting out musically with some phenomenal bands. But coming up next, more royalty. It's the queen herself.
Amy Creel.
From just north of the lake in Mandeville, it's the Fountain Blues High School Marching Band. Going way old school with that song. I remember when we were in high school and I played in the East Ascension Marching Band, and when we would have football games, all the other football schools, their bands would play that song. And coming up, it's the Tidal Float. And you know, the theme is all about candy and sweets. It's the brass from Rochester, New York, all the way down for Mardi Gras in New Orleans. I bet it's much warmer here than in Rochester right now. right, and float number four, throw me a little kiss. It's the giant fryer tuck, and of course, two gilded toilets. And the float's riders are actually walking behind, which is probably a safe bet, safer than being on the float, since everyone is using the float as target practice.
You ask him what corner. We are in the 800 block of St. Charles between Joseph Street and Julia, two blocks from Lee Circle. To Sharon Brown from Baytown, Texas. Happy Mardi Gras. No, we will not be streaming Endymion, but our partner WWL-TV will have Endymion live.
And all the way from Tennessee, but we'll be back tomorrow with a full slate of all the parades that are rolling in New Orleans tomorrow. Thanks to our sponsors, Gardner Realtors. And the next float is the Dancing Fryer float. And here comes another one of the unique marching ensembles seen in Carnival New Orleans, the Dames de Parlange from New Orleans. It's a great, great bunch. And marching with the dames are their dudes.
Brittany, how are you?
New Orleans artist Frenchie, who does live portraiture, is on this float, and he is doing a live portrait of the Tux Parade.
Is the Bel Air High School Marching Band from Baton Rouge. Give a quick shout out to Bonnie Marino. Happy Mardi Gras from Illinois. Wish you were here. Sue Ellen from Michigan. And Samantha Cochran watching from Missouri. Who dat? So here comes the next float, and since it's all things sweet, this is hot tamales and bitter honey boo-boo. Online dating and amateur beauty pageants. Yes, indeed. Thank you.
there she is, Honey Boo Boo. Music in New Orleans comes in all shapes, sizes, configurations, and what we've got right here is a group called Blue Root. It all sort of reminds us a little bit too much of after Katrina, when most of the roofs in New Orleans had a blue tarp on them and they were blue roofs. But this group, they've got it going on. Traditionally is because the royals take a break and toast the city officials down at Gallagher Hall, which used to be City Hall, but it's now where the mayor and members of the city council and their guests enjoy the carnival parades for the entire season. And tradition has it that the monarchs of the various parades will stop, exchange a few words with the mayor, and usually toast a glass of champagne. But now the parade is moving on, and our next float is Butterfingers. And let's see, it looks like we've got a mass referee or umpire on the front. Could it be a reference to some of the more unusual calls in football the last couple of years?
Maybe.
Yvette, one of the more interesting throws is the decorated plunger, in keeping with the old Tux theme. And this one has information. Take our picture with it, and we're going to tag them. So a little bit later, we're going to be doing that. And it's one of the ways that Carnival is adapting to this current age of social media. I know my daughter rides in Muses, and she put a little card in each one of her shoes to take a picture and tag her. So, Carnival comes to the internet. And just like we're live. Great to have these folks come in and get a taste of Carnival. We're glad to have them here. Now,
coming up here, Victor, this looks like a bunch of cotton candy.
It does look like a bunch of cotton candy. I wonder how excited these guys were when they saw their costumes, that they were all going to be in pink tulle. Yvette, you gotta tell me about this throw you just caught.
It's an LSU bra.
Everybody needs an LSU bra.
Absolutely. That saves, right?
And in front of us, busting a move, it's the Disco Amigos. Denny Terrio and the dance show that he used to do? With the solid gold dancers. All right, float number 11.
Payday.
Payday. Good candy bar. Good day of the week, too. Shout out to Daniel Lewis from sunny Southern California, Jane Hebert and Terry Guy Claymall. Denny Terrio hosted Dance Fever. Thank you. Yes, Dance Fever with the Solid Gold Dancers. Lori, yes, they are allowed to drink on the float. Spectators, yes.
the win, yes, it was a functional throw.
And we are on float number 11. This is payday. Yes, that was float number 11, and we are coming to you live from St. Charles Avenue in front of the offices of the Times-Picayune, the New Orleans Advocate, Gambit Weekly, and NOLA.com. I'm Victor Andrews, and with me
is Yvette DeLucky.
And we want to give a shout out to our sponsors, Gardner Realtors. And coming now,
the Muffaladas. I love this group, Victor.
Yeah, they're rocking that old-style diner look. Looking great. And you know, most of these marching groups have some sort of auxiliary that goes with them. And, of course, the Muffaladas auxiliary would have to be the Po' Boys. And they're doing a great job of sweeping the avenue of stray beads and cups so that these ladies do not bust a move, literally.
Let's give a couple of shout-outs. Lisa Lynn from upstate New York. Debbie Brunt from Ohio. Jean Denny from Ontario, Canada.
And look, and Kathy Carlson from rural Georgia. And Bonnie Lurell from Orlando. Bonnie, you miss New Orleans during Mardi Gras? Yeah, indeed, and we miss you. Colleague Sarah, who I think her one of her most favorite foods in the whole world is the next float.
Peeps.
We always try and find them for her at times other than Easter because she loves them so much. It's the Marching Buffalo Band from Baker High School.
Next.
has always had a little bit of a shady reputation. And it used to have an area called Storyville, which was filled with brothels and houses of ill repute. So Tux, of course, not satisfied to have one, has to have two. So float number 13 is brothel one and brothel two. It's like a giant Tootsie Roll, Yvette. And while we've got a little bit of a break, just to remind you, Gardner Realtors is sponsoring our live webcast from 840 St. Charles Avenue, the home offices for the Times-Picayune, the New Orleans Advocate, Gambit Weekly, and NOLA.com. We are coming at you live for the rest of the Tux Parade, but we'll be switching over to our partners, WWL, for the Endymion Parade tonight. But come back tomorrow because we will have day-long parade coverage all the way through Bacchus tomorrow night. And then, of course, on Monday night, it's Proteus, one of Carnival's oldest parading organizations. Orpheus, one of the Carnival's largest parading organizations. And then on Mardi Gras, Rex and the truck parades. It's going to be wall-to-wall parades, wall-to-wall fun, as Carnival reaches a fevered pitch here in New Orleans. And coming down the avenue right now is the John F. Kennedy High School band from right here in New Orleans. You know, Yvette, one of my favorite candies is a Jolly Rancher.
And I like the candy corn.
Well, there you go. Here they are. Jolly Rancher and Candy Corn, Sweet Treats, and the Hunters Lane High School Marching Band from Nashville, Tennessee are coming up. It's Float Number 15.
The Lifesavers of Baywatch.
Bay spelled like Beyonce Bay. Following them is the Dance Connection from Metairie. This group dates back to 1979. Absolutely. The caramel and the nougat and the chocolate, yeah. And it looks like there's a few aliens on this float. And some inflatable dolls, too. Coming down the avenue now, it's the George Washington Carver High School Marching Band from right here in New Orleans. It's a big group, Yvette. They are stretched pretty far down the avenue.
So, Victor, since you have such vast knowledge about Mardi Gras, what is the average miles that these parades roll?
Oh, it depends on exactly where they start. You know, most of the parades used to start around Napoleon and Magazine, but some of them now start even further back at Jefferson and Magazine. So they've added some a few dozen blocks to their routes, but it's quite a trek for some of these bands, and a lot of these kids will march. You know, the true parade season sort of started on Tuesday from nonstop. So some of these bands will march in a parade almost every day. That's a lot of steps.
We've had marching units parade during the day to turn around and parade again at night with a different crew.
Absolutely. And, you know, the bands do get paid to march in these parades. And for a lot of the schools, this is the only money that they get for their music programs, or what the bands get paid to march in carnival parades. One of my favorite beverages of all time, Yvette. I just absolutely love it. And here it comes down the avenue, complete with some interestingly attired young ladies in the front. It's float number 17, Eye Candy, or Tuxedos. It's a sub crew. We go from champagne to shaken, not stirred, with the Lazy Boys. Now, this is a group, I think, if I was going to do a parade of that, I think this is what I would want to do, because these guys have converted recliners, often referred to as Lazy Boys, into mobile chairs. And as you can see, they are cocked back. They have their beverages. Their smoking jackets. Even some of them even have lamps. And a little Dean Martin to go with it. And just for the record, I do like my martini shaken.
What a fun group of men.
When the sky makes the
really good driving because they're cutting donuts. They're doing all sorts of interesting little maneuvers. And I'm sure a lot of them probably couldn't pass a sobriety test right now. It's a booze cruise! Float number 19, it's hotter than hot. It's
the Atomic Fireball.
Yes, indeed. I am loving these costumes, Yvette. Yvette, as you look up and down the avenue, you can see one of the trademark tales that Tux has passed are the trees filled with toilet paper. No other crew is going to throw toilet paper but Tux, and it's become quite the spectator sport to throw the toilet paper from one side of the avenue to the other, and it gets caught in the trees, and it's an interesting decoration, I'm sure, nowhere else but New Orleans. Follow A New Orleans original pink slip. You know, it's usually Werther's Originals, but leave it to Tuts to turn it to Float 21, Friar's Original Hard Candy. Coming up now is the McKinley Senior High School Band from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. You know, Yvette, I do love a good lemon head candy.
I do as well.
But I'm not sure I like the one on the front of this float. But number 22 is lemon heads. I do like their headpieces, though.
Coming down the avenue is the Mandy Milkshakers.
You know, this is another one of those interesting marching groups, Yvette, that have cropped up in the last few years. This is a group of North Shore folks, and they're borrowing heavily on that old 1950s diner motif thing. And these gals are getting out there, and they are putting it on the street. Of course, their support team are the Milkmen.
Shout out to Deanna. She's watching from Portland, Tennessee. I hope you're enjoying this live coverage. It's brought to you by Gardner Realtors. And we are coming to you live from the Times-Picayune New Orleans Advocate NOLA.com and the Gambit here on St. Charles in downtown New Orleans. Now, Victor, this float that's coming up reminds me of my childhood.
Elvis?
No, not Elvis. Now or later?
Now and later.
And coming down the avenue is the Heidelberg High School marching band from Heidelberg, Mississippi. That we've got float number 24, Pirates of the Quarter on the Rum Sucker. Celebrating their 10th anniversary are the Organ Grinders, another one of the fabulous marching groups that walk down the streets of New Orleans during Carnival.
Three Musketeers and Milk Dudes.
do. Yes, John, that was a pirate ship. Have Jim Listell watching from their new home in upstate New York.
Alrighty, Deb. I think everybody really loves M&M's, and obviously Tugs does too, but they put their own spin on it, and coming down the avenue is S&M's, Naughty Candy.
Heather Vaughn. She said this looks like a lot of fun. She's from Longview, Texas. You think this is a lot of fun?
I think it's a lot of fun. Having been to Longview, it's a beautiful city. I don't think they have anything like this in Longview.
Thank you. listening to Hammond High School from Hammond, Louisiana. Float 27, Friar Tuck.
And in fact, it's the namesake for this crew, the Friar Tuck's Bar, which is to be located in the Ferret area, over by Tulane and Loyola. In Hattiesburg, Mississippi, is the Hattiesburg High School Tiger Marching Band. Just a reminder, folks, we usually broadcast the Endymion Parade, but tonight, because Endymion has changed their routes, we're going to be switching over to our partners, WWL, for their live webcast of the parade. But we've still got more tucks to come here on St. Charles Avenue in New Orleans, at the home of the Times-Picayune and the New Orleans Advocate here on St. Charles. And next up is float number 28, Robin Hood. And a big, big shout out to our sponsors, Gardner Realtors. Okay, Donna Breland, thanks so much. Friar Tuck's was on Claiborne Avenue across the street from Erskine Academy and the Frosttop. That right there by Tulane, the back of Tulane on Claiborne. And North Louisiana, East Carroll Parish, the Lake Providence High School Band. The Panthers have just come down the avenue, and heading right behind it is another float. It's Taste the Rainbow, Skittles, and it's a very interesting float. We've got Stefan Carmian, who is watching from northern Spain. Muchas gracias. Is the Sunshine Brass Band. You know, it's from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Willy Wonka's Everlasting Gobstopper. But of course, Tux is going to change it to Everlasting Knob Hopper. You know, I think I see a few Oompa Loompas on this float.
Just a few.
A few. From Ascension Parish, it's the Donaldsonville High School Tigers Marching Band. And heated pools, you gotta love them. Lamented in the 80s, just say no to crack. A salute to the Sheriff of Nottingham, Nottingham, and Nottingham 2. All right, Yvette, you can't have a parade where the monarch sits on a toilet and not have a special place. And of course, Tugs, float number 34, it's
the royal throne.
Absolutely. The royal outhouse, even. And from LaRanger, Louisiana, the LaRanger High School Marching Wolfpack Band. We got a shout out to Nicholas Gar from Kodiak, Alaska. And Bob Jennings, Mrs. New Orleans. Tracy Sanders is watching from Melbourne, Florida. Hi, Tracy. And up next, it's the Royal Bathtub. Only Tux would have a bathtub with a slide. And from Baton Rouge, the Madison Prep Stampede of Soul Band. Thank you. And coming up next event, one of the signature floats of Tux is the Funky Tux float. I am loving the caged dancers. It reminds me of Goldie Hawn in the original Lapin.
Victor, I think you're showing your age.
I am showing my age. This is our last float in Tux. Number 37 is the Funky Uncle Lounge. The funk just keeps rolling in on Tux. WWL will be taking over for the webcast for that. But be back tomorrow. We've got a full day of parades, and we're going to be broadcasting right here again. Be safe and have a great carnival.
Thank you.